Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, your brother Muhammad West. Yeah, at the burial ground of Shaykh Abdul Qadi as-Salam, better known in Cape Town as Shaykh Tuan Guru, may Allah have mercy on him. This Imam has a very special place for us here in Cape Town, in fact the whole of South Africa. Just a little bit about the Imam, the Shaykh. Shaykh Tuan Guru was from Indonesia, came from a religious family, came from a very noble family. And he was alive during the 1700s when the Dutch had colonized Indonesia. And part of the colonial process was, of course, to fight Islam. And the Sheikh dedicated his life to oppose the Dutch and to preserve the deen. Unfortunately, the Imam lost and he was captured by the Dutch. And in his 60s, so a 60-year-old man, he was taken away from his family, taken from his community, and he was basically dumped here, the end of the world, the bottom of the world, in Africa, in Cape Town, South Africa. And the Sheikh spent over 10 years incarcerated in his 60s in Robben Island. This is more than 100 years before Nelson Mandela went to Robben Island. Sheikh Tuan Guru was in Robben Island in jail for more than 10 years. He's released in his 70s, and subhanallah, the Imam starts from scratch. He was able to write the Quran from memory. He was a Hafidh al-Quran. He wrote the first Mus'haf here in Cape Town from memory. There was this tiny Muslim community, and so he served as the Imam. At that time, Islam was an outlawed religion, and so they would have Jumu'ah out in a quarry. And he started a madrasa next to a house. That house belonged to a lady, a sister, who was a Muslim. And when she passed away, she bequeathed this house and the madrasa to the Sheikh, and he started the first masjid called Awwal Masjid. The Sheikh would live another 10 years or so and then pass away, but from him the Cape Muslim community then developed, and from that one masjid, that first masjid, we have over 300 masjids here in Cape Town. We have a rich legacy of Hufadh, first Hafidh Madrasa from Sheikh Tuan Guru. He wrote a number of books about fiqh, about aqidah, teaching the basics. So for this Imam, subhanallah, I imagine you must have been feeling broken when he was taken away. But he comes here and he starts an entirely new community, strange land, strange language, and subhanallah, how many millions of people have been influenced for the last 300 years because of this great Imam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him. We cannot measure the contributions any of us do. We don't know what seeds we plant that will ultimately grow into a massive tree on our scales on the day of Qiyamah. How can we measure the role the Imam plays in our life? Join us, the IDP, as we look to build a community of Imams across the Southern African region, who through them will change and enhance the lives of thousands of people. Support us, the IDP, as we build a community of Imams to build strong communities. Your brother in Islam, Muhammad West. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.